Hi and welcome back. It's a very long time since I uploaded any video that were on anatomy. I think I will restart uploading class videos on anatomy, better late than never. We will restart our series on embryology. We were in season 1. We already saw episode 1, which discussed fertilization. And today we will continue with season 1, episode 2, that is cleavage. At the end of fertilization, what we have is a two-celled zygote that we saw already, and we will continue that from that point. Okay. Cleavage is defined as a repeated mitotic divisions of the zygote to form a structure called blastocyst. So cleavage is the name given to the events that happen from the stage of two cells, that is what we get at the end of fertilization, to a stage called blastocyst. During cleavage, due to this repeated mitotic divisions, the cells become increasingly smaller, and this occurs while the zygote is still within the uterine tube, while the zygote is still within the uterine tube traveling towards the uterus. And remember, the zygote is still surrounded by zona pellucida. Okay, we will bring back our 3D animation. We saw that at the end of fertilization, the zygote is of two cells, but here both the cells are of not equal size, but one cell is larger than the other. So the cytoplasmic division is unequal. One cell gets more of cytoplasm than the other, making that cell larger. So the point is, of the two cells, one is larger and one is smaller. Now here, the usual layman expectation is both the cells start dividing simultaneously, giving rise to four cells. But that is not the case. The larger cell divides first, giving rise to a three-cell stage. Then the smaller cell follows, thereby making it four cells. This process continues to 8 cells and to 16 cells. The 16-cell stage is termed as morula. As the zygote reaches a 16-cell stage, we give it a new name, that is morula. The cell division continues, and within the morula, the cells come to be arranged in two groups, the inner group called embryoblasts and the outer covering cells called tropoblast. And remember, all this happens when the embryo is still covered by zona pellucida and it is still moving slowly from the ampulla of the uterine tube to the uterine cavity. So when all this is happening, the structure is slowly moving from the ampulla of the uterine tube where the fertilization occurs to the uterine cavity. Somewhere in the way, it loses the corona radiata, but the zona pellucida is still present. It is at about this stage, that is the stage of morula, that the embryo reaches the uterine cavity. Now, what is there in the uterine cavity? The nutrient-rich uterine fluid, which is secreted by the uterine endometrium. This nutrient-rich uterine fluid now enters the intercellular spaces of morula. First, the nutrient-rich fluid enters the intercellular spaces, and then these fluid-filled spaces coalesce to form a single large cavity called blastocyst cavity. And at this stage, we give a new name to the embryo, that is blastocyst. As more and more uterine fluid enters and the cavity enlarges, the embryoblast, which is the inner mass of cells, yes, the embryoblast compacts and is pushed to one side, and that side is called embryonic pore. So what we have now here is the outer tropoblast And then the inner embryoblast cells push to one side, and the rest of the area, which forms the blastocyst cavity, filled with uterine fluid. The entire thing is surrounded by zona pellucida, and this structure is called blastocyst. We will continue the story of blastocyst, but before that, I will have to digress to a side story, that is hatching of blastocyst. Now, after the formation of blastocyst, and when the structure is already in the uterine cavity, the zona pellucida, which stays up to this point, now disappears. Remember, the outer layer of cells of the blastocyst, that is the trophoblast, these trophoblast cells has the property of sticking to anything that comes across. Okay, they are kind of sticky cells, fibriquick cells, which sticks to any structure that comes across or they meet. Until now, they are shielded by the zona pellucida. But now that the zona pellucida disappears, this trophoblast shows its true nature. It sticks to the endometrium. It not only sticks to the endometrium, it also burrows the endometrium and goes deep into the endometrium and lies there. This sticking is called implantation, and this burrowing and going deep into the endometrium and attaching there within the endometrium is called interstitial implantation. Well, it's time now to dispel another layman myth. The popular belief is that the embryo grows within the uterine cavity, but that is not true actually. The embryo grows, as we saw here, within the uterine endometrium. The embryo grows implanted within the uterine endometrial tissue, not in the uterine cavity. We will come to this implantation and continue the story of implantation further when we discuss placenta in some other season. So for the time being, we will leave this side story here and come back to our blastocyst. What happens to this blastocyst? We will continue that story. Coming to the fate of blastocyst, the inner mass of cells, that is embryoblast, gives rise to the actual embryo. The outer layer, trophoblast, takes part in the formation of the supporting structure, that is the placenta, and the blastocoel, that is the cavity, forms the yolk sac. How all these happen, we will see in detail, but that will be in our next episode, that is season 1, episode 3. Okay, so that's all for this episode. As usual, I have provided notes in the description. And for further guidance or live online classes, you can contact me. Until we meet in our next episode, thanks for watching. Bye.